Sean, your broker extraordinaire, and it's this week's Tuesday meeting here at St. Augustine Team Realty. It's May 24th, 2011. I got my white, it's a ribbed t-shirt. It's nice. It's, you know, it's not just a white Hanes t-shirt. It's 92 or 95 degrees outside, and it's sweltering, so I'm going to dress down a little bit today. Let's jump into it. Quite a few things on the thing today, on the agenda today, but I'll go over them as quick as I can. Stay tuned for the last part. It's fun. It's real estate fun, as real estate stories always are. First thing, no training this week. Thanks for those of you who attended the training the last 2 weeks on listings. As far as listings go, we always need them. Listings are the lifeblood of a real estate company. One thing that listings do is they bring in a lot of new buyers. They bring in new interest. It's fresh blood. So we've got some people that are pretty dedicated buyers agents. We're not asking you to be who you aren't, but bringing good price listings, and they will sell, and they will keep you, keep other people working on weekends while you are not working. So that's why I like listings. Peter brought one in this week. Our buyer's specialist. This is his own property, so this is might be the only property he lists in the next millennia. It's on 11 Maryland. It's in Madeira Heights, which is right across from the amphitheater. This is kind of the Lighthouse Park district, just adjacent to Davis Shores. 189.9. It's your classic St. Augustine concrete, brick over concrete block on the island, ranch home. Beautiful. Take a look. Again, 189.9, three bedrooms, two baths. And then we have a price reduction. Timber Trace is back on the market. It's not a price reduction, but it's $139.9, four bedrooms in Whisper Ridge. It's a fantastic home. Go and show it. Tonight, on Tuesday, there's a mixer starting at 5:30 at Island Burgers on the island. Hold on one second. It is at, here it is, here's the flyer right here, at 2085 A1A South, number 206. I don't know where that is. I don't. I'm thinking it's in the plaza with the Anastasia Billiards, but I'm not 100% sure. It might be south of that, so I gotta go find it myself on Google tonight. But it starts at 5:30. I'm gonna try and be there. I'm watching the kids tonight. I might bring the kids. You know, why not? Let's see. Homepath. Yesterday, I attended some training with Carol Alford of PNC Mortgage, and she went over the Fannie Mae Homepath. Basically, Fannie Mae Homepath are homes that have been foreclosed on and are owned by Fannie Mae. You can buy these homes for 3% down. There's no PMI. There's no appraisal. If it doesn't appraise, if there's other financing that you have to use on a Homepath home and it doesn't appraise, there's some criteria on that. But if you go straight Homepath, it's 3% down, no PMI, no appraisals. If you're an investor or you're buying it as a second home, you have to wait 14 days after it's been on the market to put in your offer. In other words, Fannie Mae wants the people that are buying it, or wants to give the first chance to people who are buying it, who are going to use it as their primary residence. If it stays on the market 14 days or more, you can buy it through Homepath as an investor or as a second home buyer, and you need to put 10% down, but again, no PMI, no appraisal, so it's a really good deal. Come see me if you need some more information on it. So Stephen Collins from Land Title stopped in yesterday just to remind everyone that on the new FAR bar contract, the seller pays the title endorsements for the buyer, especially in a cash sale. In a financing situation, I'd have to check the contract, but typically you only see buyer endorsements. In the old days, you only saw buyer endorsements when there was a mortgage on it, and the buyer typically paid for those mortgage endorsements. In the case of cash, the seller is paying for those endorsements. I have to double check that. I don't think I've got it quite right, but it's, you know, a couple extra, like 130 or 150 bucks in closing costs. And of course, sellers are going nuts, you know. So if you get it's a really good thing to have for the seller, because it protects the buyer down the line, which means if there are problems down the line, typically the seller won't have to hear about it, because again, you're giving a warranty deed, and the seller says that they're going, you know, in giving a warranty deed to a buyer, you're promising that you will defend it from title defects as the seller. And if you buy these buyer title endorsements, you may never, and something comes up, you may never ever hear about it, whereas if these title endorsements aren't there, you might hear about it, you might get sued. pretty rare when it's going to happen, but it's for, you know, $100 or $200. It's really good insurance to have because it's insurance that lasts essentially your lifetime. As long as you hold that title and hold those endorsements and keep them in a safe box somewhere, you know, you'll have title insurance that ostensibly will protect you from that. So just, you know, be aware if you have a seller, and there's, especially if there's a cash buyer on the other side, they might pay in a couple extra $100 for title endorsements, you know, and if that's an issue, then the price is $230,000. Make it $230,200. Please. Okay. Last thing, EDO. EDO is an escrow disbursement order. And this is where the fun part of real estate meetings always come in, the real estate stories. We've got one in this office. Basically what happens, buyer goes out and puts an offer in on a mobile home. They've got a pre-approval letter from a large local lender with a large national presence. And their closing costs were supposed to be X. So they come back to the lender with this contract for a mobile home, and the lender says, because it's a mobile home, your closing costs are double what we estimated they were before on just like a single family home. Okay, buyers can't afford the closing costs, you know, because they had enough to pay the closing costs for a home, but since that they have now doubled, they don't have enough money in the bank to cover that, therefore they can't get the financing, or maybe they could get the financing, but they can't cover the closing costs. You know, right? So they cancel the contract, and then without telling the realtor, they go out and buy a for sale by owner, you know, and they need their escrow deposit, you know, their binder money, their earnest money deposit that they put on the old mobile home to buy whatever it is they're buying for sale by owner. They didn't tell the realtor that they went and did this. Well, the seller does not contest this, you know, giving their money back, but he just won't sign the paper. And they wait, and they wait, and they wait. So I find out about it, and I go through the contract, and I look at it, and the contract says a buyer has to make application. This is the new FAR bar contract. You know, they have to make application in 5 days, have to provide written proof of financing in 30 days. You know how that works. Well, anyway, even though it's a common sense decision not to make application after you just, in other words, why would you spend $400 to make application just to be denied the loan because you can't make the closing costs, which you know ahead of time anyway, right? So they don't make application, but the contract says they have to make application. So if they have to make application, can I by law legally let the money go or order the title company to release the money? I can't, you know, I'm probably right. Would be right in letting them do it, but I'm not allowed to do it. So I have to send it to the state as an escrow disbursement order. So just be aware of things like that. Really pay attention to your contracts. If you know somebody or suspect somebody's gonna try and break a contract, send them to an attorney. I mean, please do it, because an attorney can interpret and tell them, you know, we as realtors can say, this is what might happen, but an attorney can tell them more than likely, they can give them legal advice. We can't give them legal advice. You know, we can just give them kind of guidance within our scope, within the law. So in other words, you got people who are waiting for their escrow, and now they have to wait for the state to issue the EDO. The state might give the money to the sellers, the state might give it to the buyers. We think they'll give it to the buyers, but they might not, and they might lose their money. So anyway, if you ever get a situation like that where a contract's gonna be broke, always, you know, and put it in writing, email, fax, whatever, say, yeah, I can't give you legal advice on this, see an attorney. Just for a $200 or $300 consultation, it would be worth your money. So that's it, and I will talk to you next week. You're the best in the business. Thank you for being part of St. Augustine Team Realty. And again, talk to you next week.